Students, the problem given here is f of x is equal to interval 0 is less than x, x is less than pi, and f of x is equal to cos x, pi by 4 is less than x, as a Fourier series, Fourier sine series expansion. F x as a Fourier sine series expansion. To write the formula of this expansion for f of x, the general form between 0 comma is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity bn. Now the limits have been given between 0, here pi by 2 has problem, the interval is between 0 to pi by 2. Now f of x can be according to the given limits, it is sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity pi x divided by l pi by 2. Will be getting cancelled each other, 2 will go to the numerator and it is 1 to infinity bn sine 2 nx. Now the point bn, the general is when the interval is 0 to l, 2 divided by l integral of 0 to l f of x divided by the interval is between 0 to, in the place of l we need to substitute pi by 2, so bn is equal to pi by 2 integral of g by 2 f of x nx into dx. This will become 4. The function defined in two intervals, one is from 0 to pi by 4, another one is 4 to pi by 2. So the f of x has to be substituted for these two intervals. Now b is equal to 4 divided by pi integral of g pi by 4 into nx into dx plus integral of pi by 4 to pi by 2 f of x into sine 2 nx dx it is. Now the function between the intervals 0 to pi by 4 x and between the interval pi by 4 to pi by 2 is cos x, and they are substituted in the form to 4 into integral of 0 to pi by 4 f of x, here it is sine x 2 nx dx plus integral of pi by 4 to pi by 2, here f of x is cos x 2 nx into dx. Now look into these two integrals. The first integral sine x is of the model sine a sine b. Sine a sine b can be written as 1 by 2 into cos a minus b minus of cos a plus b. And look into the second integral sine 2 nx into cos x, it is of the form sine a cos b. Sine a cos b can be written as 1 by 2 into sine a plus b plus sine minus b. Now let you substitute these two formulas here. Now this, as per the formula 1 by 2 is coming, the 1 by 2 is taken outside, so the multiplication factor outside will become 2 divided by pi. Integral of 0 to pi by 4 cos 2 nx minus x, so it is written as cos of 2 n minus 1 into x minus cos of a plus b is a is 2 nx, b is x, and 2nx plus x will be written as minus cos of 2n plus 1 into x into dx. For the second integral, integral of pi by 4 to pi by 2 sine of a is 2nx, b x, so it is written as sine of 2n plus 1 into x plus sine of a minus b. A here it is 2nx, b is minus x, and it is written as 2n minus 1 into x dx. Now separate the terms, it is 2 divided cos 2nx minus 1 into x, integration of cos is sine, so sine 2nx x divided by this, now 2n minus 1, 2n minus 1 of x is 2n minus 1. The second term it is minus cos 2 n plus 1 into x. So minus sin 2 n plus 1 into x, limits are applied between g and the third term is sin 2 plus 2n. The integration of sin is minus cos, so 2n plus 1 into differentiation of 2n plus 1, differentiation of 2n plus 1 into 2n minus 1 into x minus cos, so minus 2n dx divided by the differentiation of 2n minus x, it is applied between pi by that you apply the limits for the first bracket pi by side. So the first into x divided by 2, when pi by 2 pi by 4 here, it will become sin 2n minus 1. The place of x pi by 4 as sin of 2n minus 1 into pi by 4 divided by 2n minus 1. And when you apply the lower limit, sin 2n minus 1 into x will become sin 0. Sin 0 is equal to 0. Application of limits to the second term. 1 into x divided by 2n. Applying the upper limit, minus sin is already there, so minus sin of 2n plus 1 into, in the place of x pi by 4 is substituted, divided by 2n plus 1. Apply the lower limit, sin 2n plus 1 will become sin 0, sin 0 is equal to 0. Now let us go for the third term. When you apply the upper limit, third term minus cos 2n plus 1, it will become minus cos 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. And 2n plus 1 into pi by 2, and n may be any integer. When n is multiplied by an even number, it will be an even, will become 2n plus 1 will always be an odd number, into pi by 2. And an odd number into pi by 2, it is equal to cos of an odd number to pi by 2, it is equal to 0. Similarly, minus cos 2 upper limit, 2 into any integer minus 1, it will 2n minus 1 is an odd number. Applied for x of an odd number into pi by 2 will always be equal to 0. Of an odd number into pi by 2 will always be equal to 0. Here we have written this as cos of 2 plus or minus 1 into pi. So when you apply third term, it is now when you apply the third term, the lower limit as per for sign coming, this minus of minus will become plus, and it is pi by 4 divided by 2n plus 1. Similarly, when you apply the lower limit for the fourth term, as per the formula minus sign will be coming, there is already a minus, minus of minus will become plus, it is cos of 2n minus 1 into pi by 4 divided by 2n minus 1. Now each and every term in the numerator is to be expanded. So the first term is sin of 2n into pi by 4, it will become minus pi by 4. So sin of 2n minus 1 into pi by 4 will become sin of n pi by 2 minus pi by 4. It is of the form sin a minus b form. The expansion for sin a minus b is sin a cos b, and sin a cos b is cos pi by, cos a is cos n pi by 2, and sin b is. For the second term, again sin pi by 4, it is format, and sin a is sin b, and minus sin is written as it is, sin a sin n pi by 2 into cos b cos pi by 4 plus cos a cos n pi by 2 in divided by 2n plus 1 it is. Look into the third term, it is cos n pi by 4, it is, so cos a plus b equal to cos a cos b minus sin cos n pi by 2 minus sin into sin b is sin pi by 4 divided by 2n plus 1. And look into the fourth term, it is cos of n pi by 2 minus pi by 4, it is cos a minus b format. So cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. So cos A is cos n pi by 2, cos B is cos pi by 4, sin A is sin n pi by 2 into cos B is cos A cos B plus sin B. So it is not cos here, it is sin. It is sin pi by 4. And all the has been expanded. Now you have to apply the even sin n pi by 2 is equal to, now let you go to the previous are becoming 0. Now wherever sin n pi by 2 comes, it is equal to 0. So the first term will be becoming 0. And this term will be becoming 0. And this term will be becoming 0. And this term will be becoming 0. And sin n pi by 2 is equal to 0, you have to analyze. Sin n will be substituted as 2, 6. For example, let you, when n is equal to 2, 2 pi divided by 2, it is becoming sin divided by 2, it is becoming sin pi, sin pi is equal to 0. When n is equal to 4, sin 4 pi divided by 2, it is equal to 0. So similar sage, wherever you have made sin n pi by 2 is equal to, now you look into the denominator, 2n minus 1 and 2n minus 1 is there, and there are two terms, cos n pi by 2 into sin pi by 4 . Now let you find out the values for the remaining terms. Cos minus cos n pi by 2 by 4, sin pi by 4 is 1 by root 2. So it is written as cos n pi by 2 into 1 by root 2 divided by 2n minus 1. And similarly, here sin pi by 4 is here, there, or here the sin pi by 4, cos n pi by 2 into sin pi by 4. So it is written as cos n pi by 2 into 1 by root 2 divided by 2n plus 1. And similarly, here in the third term also, there is cos n pi by 2 into cos pi by 4. Cos pi by 4 is also cos 45 degree. Cos 45 degree is, it is written as 1 by root 2. So it is by 2 into 1 by root 2 divided by 2n plus 1. Fourth term also, and into cos pi by 4 is there, and it is cos n pi by 2 into 1 by root 2 divided by 2n minus 1. And from the previous slide you have analyzed the values. So now let us write the values for bn as 2 divided by pi minus cos n pi by 2 into 1 by root 2 divided by 2n minus 1 minus cos n pi by 2 into 1 by root 2 divided by 2n plus 1 and cos n pi by 2 into 1 by root 2 divided by 2n plus 1 and 1 by root 2 into by 2 divided by 2n minus 1. Now, looking into the terms, look into the denominator 2n minus 1 and you look into the term 2n minus 1. The numerators, one is positive, the numerators are identical, one is positive and one is negative, they will be getting cancelled each other. And look into the denominator 2n plus 1 terms and the numerators are identical and one is minus, another one is plus. So they will also be getting net value for bn is equal to 0 when n is even. Now let us go for odd, cos n pi by 2 is equal to 0. Now look into the terms, when n is odd, cos n pi by 2 will be becoming 0. Cos of odd number into pi by 2 will always be equal to 0, we have already analyzed. cos n pi by 2 into sin pi by 4 is into sin pi by 4 is 0, and cos n pi by 2 into cos pi by 4 is 0, and cos n pi by 2 into cos pi by 4 is 0. Odd sin n pi by 2 into cos pi by 4, it is written as 2 divided by 2n minus 1. Similarly, minus sin n pi by 2, sin minus sin n pi by 2 into 1 by root 2 divided by plus 1 will be there, and plus sin n pi by 2 into 1 by root 2 divided by 2n minus 1 term will be there. Now when n is odd, bn is written as 2 divided by pi into 1 by root 2. It is commonly taken outside because all the terms are having 1 by root 2. Sin n pi by 2 divided by 2n minus 1 minus sin n is 1 plus, sorry, minus sin n pi by 2 divided by 2n plus 1 plus sin n pi by 2 divided by 2n plus 1. Now look into the denominator, 2n minus 1, so it is written as 2 sin n pi by plus 1, and the numerators are minus sin n pi by 2 for both the terms. It is written as minus 2 sin n pi by 2 divided by 2n plus 2 divided by pi into 1 by root 2 is 2 can be written as 2 can be written as root 2 into root 2. This numerator 2, there is 1 root 2, so 1 root 2 will get cancelled. So it is root 2 divided by pi minus 2 sin n pi by 2 divided by 2n plus 1 plus 2 sin n pi by 2 divided by 2n. Root 2 divided by pi, 2 sin n pi by 2 is commuted into 2 root sin n pi by 2. Bracket will be 1 divided by 2n minus 1 minus of 1 divided by 2n plus 1. By pi sin n pi by 2 sin n pi by 2, and will be 2n minus 1 into 2n plus 1. The numerator will become plus 1 minus 2n plus 1, and 2n will be getting cancelled each other, so the numerator term will become 4. So it is equal to 2 into root 2 divided by pi sin n pi by n pi by 2 into 2 divided by 4n squared minus 1, and it is written as 4 into root 2 divided by pi sin of n pi by 2 1 divided by 4n squared minus 1. Now the final step is to write the required Fourier sine series expansion for f of x. It is written as f of x is even, n is equal to even, so bn is becoming 0. So we shall write the Fourier series expansion for n is equal to odd number alone. So it is sigma n is equal to 1 comma 3 comma 5 to infinity 4 into root 2 divided by pi n pi by 2 into as per formula sine 2 nx will be there. And if you substitute, let you take it n is equal to 1, and when you substitute n is equal to 1, sin pi by 2, it will become sin n pi by 2 will become sin pi by 2, it is becoming 1, sin pi by 2, sin pi by 2 is equal to 1, and 4n squared minus 1 will be becoming 4 into 1 squared is 1, so 4 into 1 is 4, minus 1, it is 3, and sin 2x, 2nx will become 2 into 1 into x, it is sin 2x, so sin 2x divided by 3. Similarly, when you substitute n is equal to 2, the 4n squared will become 4 into 2 squared, 4 into, sorry, when n is equal to 3, you cannot substitute 2 because for even number, bn is equal to 0. 4n squared, 4 into 3 squared is 36 minus 1, it is 35. And when you substitute sin n pi by 2, n is 3, it is sin 3 pi by 2, sin pi by 2 is 90 degree. Sin 2 pi by 2 is 180 degree, sin 3 pi by 2 is 270 degree, sin 3 pi by 2 is 270 degree, sine of 270 degree is minus 1, so minus of 1 by 30 is sine 6x. Similarly, you can go for the other numbers also. So this is what the final required Fourier series expansion.